family's been here since 1875, and I'm the fifth generation. We're all organic. We've been organic for 12, 13 years now, all dairy, running 250 head of cattle, half young stock, half milking. We've been in dairy short on for pedigree for just over 100 years now, and it's a breed that's very well suited to our area. We've been with our Westmorland veterinary group for a long, long time. They've always been our vets, and we've always worked quite closely with them.
I come here once a fortnight to visit James and take care of both the adult cattle health and the young stock. We try and do both at every visit. Everything's fairly well managed at the moment at Strickley. We've done a lot of work over the last 5 or 6 years in terms of changing protocols and getting on top of things. James vaccinates his adult cattle for BVD, leptospirosis and IBR. He then vaccinates his heifers before turnout for lungworm. And then the dry cows get vaccinated for salmonella and rota and virus and coronavirus to protect the calves when they're born. And it hasn't meant a lot of big financial investments. It's maybe just meant tweaking what we've been doing and paying a little bit more attention to detail. James does a fantastic job of his colostrum management, and that is significant compared to some other farms. He religiously makes sure he gets adequate colostrum in as soon as that calf hits the deck. And that to me is making a massive difference. It also means he's getting full money from the vaccines he's putting into his dry cows because he's making sure those calves get the antibodies.
We also use calf trackers as well. We've been using them for probably getting on towards 5 years now. And in terms of making a difference to the calf, we reckon they're probably gaining about 5 kilo extra towards 100 days. And that 5 kilo extra growth can equate to perhaps 20, 30, maybe even 40 kilos difference when they are getting towards a service age. In terms of a cheap thing that you can do to improve calf health and calf growth rates, it's a real no-brainer really, yeah.
We tend to sit down probably twice a year and add up the figures for the adult cattle, so lameness, fasciitis, things like that, and come up with a plan of what we want to focus on next. The fertility data gets monitored every 2 to 3 months, but we try and make it not too laborious.
Been family farm here now for getting on towards 150 years. I'd like to see it, you know, for another 150 possibly, but you can only really just hand it over in a better state than what you took it really. So yeah, just healthy herd and healthy farm, definitely.